Okay, so we're back for round two. We won the die roll, so we're definitely going to be on the play. This hand is slow. I'm actually going to mulligan this. We've got nothing to do until turn five, which I don't think is how we're going to win the game here. This hand is better. If we hit the land, then we've got a turn three play. And so we're going to keep here. Lead on the mountain. So this may be the pacifism deck. Yep, we've got the white sauce, perfect. Straight into Lightwalker. At this point our hand's actually looking really strong. So we're definitely playing the Behemoth here, so it makes sense to just play out the mountain as opposed to the Crucible. So this shove puts quite a bit of pressure onto our opponent. They need to find an answer, they need to find one fast. Okay, it's got a morph, we're still going to attack quite happily into that. Our opponent's most likely sort of taking seven here. So they're taking seven either way. If I dash in the Warbrute, I can of course just cast the Warbrute next turn if I draw the land. Actually makes better sense to keep that hidden information and get a counter onto the Crucible. I'm quite happy to make that trade. Tobbs unfortunately had to leave, so you're stuck with just me now for the rest of the session. Yep, we saw the pacifism coming. If we don't hit the land, then we're just going to dash the Spinning Warbrute here. We've still got a heck of a lot of... a lot of stuff going on to our opponent. Against this removal kind of deck, I think it's almost certainly correct to just dash anyway. So flatten's going to be an issue next turn if he gets the fifth land out. Okay, so making himself a blocker again. But that's fine. Effects at end step. So we're one mana short of having the double dash here, which is really sad for us. I still think we force the block. 2, 4, 5. I actually want to cast the War Brute here. So it does mean that next turn we can dash and War Flare, which should be enough to just be lethal. Although if we cast with dash and he doesn't block, it's the same effect. Essentially forces the block. Nothing for his post combat. Like, we're just not giving him the opportunity. The fact he didn't block there is quite interesting. Maybe just trying to wait that extra turn. Okay. So if we dash two creatures here, we put into one. So that one mana short of being able to dash twice. Does that make Twin Bolt lethal off the top, which is probably the better plan here. Could have the Butcher's Glee. But that makes this a much less painful attack. Yeah, Butcher's Glee. Saw it coming from a mile off. Okay, so it seems to have found some blockers. He's probably going to have to double block to deal with the War Brute. So if he doesn't, he makes them morph into a 4-4. I think the correct line is just to cast the war brute. There's nothing else we can really do here. So our opponent's got okay, so what are our options here? If we attack with the war brute, yeah, let's we're not doing anything else before we go to combat here. We can then bathe the Absent Sky Captain while he's got nothing left. If he just blocks with the Sky Captain here, he makes makes the morph pretty big. No blocks. Okay. We're going to go for it. Bias. Seems actually going to end up being really close. Okay, nothing really for us to do here. I still think like we're ahead in this game. our opponent still can't attack, which is really good for us. Okay. We can just play the Harbinger and force him to have something here. I thought that was one more mana than that to cast. Okay, I'm going to focus over it now and just sort of speed up the play a little bit. Right, we get to get in for 5 Nazi blocks with the flyer. Okay. So I think the play here is to bathe the birdie. I mean, this morph has to be a flyer for us to not get blown out. Attacking. Just watch that opponent has the removal spell. Because they always have it. Like, I don't win the game by playing around that there. Actually been a really good game. And our opponent hasn't drawn very well, which is slightly worrying. Okay, he's got a 6-8, which is like, he's going to be able to start beating us down really, really quickly here. just going to make some men and try and go wide around him. Seems like my only line of play that sort of works here. No attacks. I got 6-8, so big. Shambling Goblins is fine. Sure. He's managing our board state really well. Forest is not what we're looking for here. It's getting to the point where our opponent can actually start attacking. They're going to need to, because they also have to win a second game yet. So he's now getting a bit out of control. Now we have got the Sarkhan's Rage and the Twin Bolt still left in our library, so we've got a couple of options to try and win out the game. I'm not going to sandbag wagons here. I want to do as much as I can on any particular turn. Yep, so they're now starting to feel safe enough that they can start getting in. We've got 3 turns to draw our answers. Okay. So that's the start. We're going to go on the burnout plan. We're not going to win any other way. Slightly worried this morph's never been flipped straight up. And if we attack here, we get him for 1. But then we take 6, 9, 13, 14 on the way back. Yeah, we can't attack. Something's getting bigger. Jeez, we're on the clock here now. If we don't win on the next turn and we're just dead, we need to draw the win. And if he has another Butcher's Glee, then we just can't win. Oh no, Sarkhan's Rage kills us simultaneously. Yeah, Sarkhan's Rage doesn't do it now. We need Twin Bolt. No, that's not going to do it. Wow. Okay. So the Lose Calm's going to be good here. Arc Bond's going to be good here. Collateral Damage is going to be good here. I'm going to drop the War Flare because it's just not doing enough for us. Maybe collateral damage isn't so great. I'm not sure what the other cut is here. I'm really not. It's maybe Arishin. She's just too slow. Okay, so we have 11 minutes to win two games. This is going to happen real quick. And we can't keep that. This, however, we can. Yeah, we're just going to dash this here. If he wants to trade, then fine. He's going to trade for that eventually anyway. Quite happy making that trade in the early game. Deal. Just going to dash in and get him for as much damage as we possibly can. Okay, making another Shaman Goblin is fine, and Glaring Aegis is going to hurt us a little bit here. think the only way we actually win this is if our opponent times out, if they have more decisions to make. I mean, we are winning the damage race. Okay, so we hit the right land, that's fine. We now get to dash in and then come with a light walker. We're feeling somebody's just brought a puppy in to see me. Yep, losing that there is quite painful for us. Yeah, we're not being the straw of my opponent. Wow, they're playing a lot of one drops. Okay, Behemoth can help. There's no reason for them not to attack with the rats there. It's really bad that the warbird's just going to trade with the rats, but... we really don't have any other sort of options here. We could draw to Wimbo, which is quite a good draw for us. So just going to eat a rat. Activate so I can skip through as much as possible. Yep, we're probably dead next turn. The pyrotechnic saves us. Bathing Dragonfire, I don't think, is enough. Yeah, we're just dead. So we'll be back in a minute for round three.